Welcome to all 6th standard students to our subject grammar. And today we will discuss our first chapter, exercise 4, 5 and 6. Lesson number 1, exercise 4, 5 and 6. So please take your textbook, page number 4 and 5. These exercises are there on page number 4 and 5. So you just take your textbook also. So let's start exercise 4. The question is very clear. Write interrogative sentences which would be answered by the given statements. So answers are given there. Exercise 4, the clear answer is given there. We need to write the questions, which means interrogative sentences. So based on this answer, you need to prepare the question. That is your task. Once again, write interrogative sentences which would be answered by the given statements. So let's start. The first one is, I will pack my bag after breakfast. What will be its answer? When will you pack your bag? So answer is clearly there. I will pack my bag after breakfast. Now next one, second one. It is 1 kilometer wide. The question is, it is 1 kilometer wide, and we need to prepare its question. That is, how wide is it? And the question mark is compulsory. How wide is it? Third one is, answer is given there. Prometheus brought fire to the earth from heaven. And we need to prepare its question. And the question is, who brought fire to the earth from heaven? Now the fourth one is, the answer is clearly given there. I cannot close this window because its frame has bent. So write the question. Why can't you close the window? Why can't you close the window? Now fifth one, the answer is clearly given there. Anshuman Ram is a golfer. And we need to make its question form. Who is Anshuman Ram? Answer is clearly given there in the textbook. Now sixth one. This mobile phone is my mother's. That is the answer given there on exercise 4, sixth one. We need to prepare its question. So the question is, whose mobile phone is this? Now seventh one, the answer is there. There are 13 birds in the picture. We need to prepare its question. So the question is, how many birds are there in the picture? How many birds are there in the picture? Now eighth one, the answer is clearly given there. I went to watch a movie last evening. So we need to prepare a question for that. And the question is, Where did you go last evening? Where did you go last evening? Ninth one, answer is there. Rafiq's house is in Manohar Nagar. We need to prepare a question for that, and the question is, where is Rafiq's house located? Where is Rafiq's house located? Now, tenth one. This train will reach Dehradun at 4 o'clock in the morning. So we need to write a question for that one. Write a question. When will this train reach Dehradun? When will this train reach Dehradun? So exercise 4, once again, the clear answers are given there on exercise 4. That answers, based on that answers, you need to prepare questions for that. So this is exercise 4, questions are prepared. Now we can go for exercise 5. The question is, the main question is very clear. Write imperative sentences that can be used in each of the following situations. Some situations are given there, and in these situations, we need to prepare some imperative sentences based on these situations. Already you know what is imperative sentences. Imperative sentences, maybe that will be commands, or that will be suggestions, or any type of a request. These all the things are there in imperative sentences section. So some situations are given there on textbook page number 5, exercise 5. We need to prepare some imperative sentences based on these situations. So let's start. Request, once first situation, request Shoaib to turn off the lights in the bedroom. So we need to, it's a request form, so we need to prepare for that type of a sentence. So just request him, Shoaib, please turn off the lights in the bedroom. That is the first one answer. Now second one, a warning on an electric iron that one should not touch it with wet hands. So in that situation, we need to give a command or an order to them, a warning to them. So the sentence will be, don't touch with wet hands. The situation is very clear, that is there on textbook. Now third situation, a website asking you to enter a password to log in. You need to enter a password to log in a website. So in that situation, what type of a sentence, or how to prepare an imperative sentence? That is, please enter your password to log in. It's a request form. Please enter your password to log in. Now fourth one, a coach shouting to his student during a running competition. The situation is clear. A coach shouting to his student during a running competition. So it's a command form is there. So we can write there, run fast. Answer is run fast. Now fifth situation, instruction to stick a photograph on an application form. You need to paste an application, a photograph in an application form. So what type of imperative sentence you can write there? Paste your photograph here. Now sixth one, sign at a public place asking people to throw litter in the dustbin. So that is also a request form to throw litter in the dustbin. So we can convert that imperative sentence as a request sentence. We need to write like this: please throw litter in the dustbin. Now seventh one, an emergency situation is given there. An emergency helpline number and the accompanying message. So in that situation, we just imagine one emergency number, and that based on that emergency number we can write our sentence. So just write there 1800, call in case of any emergency. Now next situation, eighth one, a line from a recipe not on adding ginger. That is the situation. So we need to make an imperative sentence for this situation. So the situation, the sentence will be: add a little ginger. Add a little ginger. So exercise 5 is clear. Some situations are given there. Based on that situations, you need to write some imperative sentences. Imperative sentences may be request form is there, order form is there, command form is there. So you just read out that sentences, then you can understand that which type of sentences are this. Then based on that situation is this, then based on that situation you can prepare the imperative sentences this form. So let's start exercise 6. Rewrite the following statements as exclamations. We need to complete this 8 sentences are given there, 8 statements are given there. That 8 statements we need to complete with exclamation mark. So any exclamation sentence, that is very clear. Exclamatory sentences are given very, very clear there. Are strong feelings. So let's start our exercise. The first question is, the tadpoles are tiny. So we just write already in the exclamatory sections. We have already learned that one. For making exclamation or exclamatory sentences, the words commonly we are using how and what. So here also we need to, we prepared the sentences based on, or the starting word is with how and what. So let's start. The tadpoles are tiny. We need to write the complete, convert these statements to exclamation mark. So how it will come? How tiny the tadpoles are. Then exclamation mark, not full stop. Now next one, second one, the statement is, it is very silly to paint an ice cube. We need to convert that one into an exclamatory sentence. So the exclamatory sentence will be, how silly it is to paint an ice cube. Now third situation is, the third statement is, the Grand Canyon in America is an amazing sight. We need to convert into exclamatory sentence. So the sentence will be, what an amazing sight the Grand Canyon in America. What an amazing sight the Grand Canyon in America. Fourth one, Kuldeep Basu is a wonderful fielder. We need to convert into exclamatory sentence. So the sentence will be, the statement will be, what a wonderful fielder Kuldeep Basu is. What a wonderful fielder Kuldeep Basu is. Now fifth one, the socks Rohini Nair are very fluffy. That is a statement we need to convert into exclamatory sentence. So the exclamatory sentence will be, how fluffy the socks Rohini Nair's are. How fluffy the socks Rohini Nair's are. Now sixth one, the statement is, it is dangerous to play with firecrackers. And the statement, sorry, the exclamatory sentence we need to convert to that one. How dangerous it is to play with firecrackers. How dangerous it is to play with firecrackers. Now seventh one, the rotten meat is very smelly. That is the statement we need to convert into exclamatory sentence. How smelly the rotten meat is. How smelly the rotten meat is. Now eighth one, statement is, Reena Naidu is a talented chess player. We need to convert into exclamatory sentence. So what a talented chess player Reena Naidu is. So exercise 4, 5 and 6 is completed. Your first chapter is over. Now this exercise 4, 5 and 6 copy to your notebook so that your first chapter notebook work is also over. And this PDF format I will send there in the classroom application.